Now let's talk about the mechanisms that are there in exokernel for implementing these secure bindings. There are three methods. The first method is hardware mechanisms. And I gave you this example of a TLB entry. Other examples of hardware mechanisms include getting a physical page frame from exokernel or a portion of the frame buffer that is being used by the display. These are all examples of specific hardware resources that can be requested by the library operating system and can be bound to that library operating system by exokernel and exported to the library operating system as an encrypted key. And once the library operating system has the encrypted key for that resource, it can use that anytime it wants. The second mechanism that exokernel has is software caching on behalf of each library operating system. Specifically, the shadow TLB or caching the hardware TLB in a software cache for each library operating system is to avoid the context switch penalty when exokernel switches from one library operating system to another. Basically, what will happen is that at the point of context switch, exokernel will dump the hardware TLB into a software TLB data structure that is associated with that specific library operating system, and similarly load the software TLB of the library operating system to which it is switching to into the hardware TLB. We will talk about this mechanism in much more detail shortly, but at this point, I wanted to mention that this is a second mechanism that exists in exokernel for establishing a secure binding between a library operating system and the hardware. The third mechanism that exokernel has for establishing a secure binding on behalf of an operating system is downloading code into the kernel. This is simply to avoid border crossing by inserting specific code that an operating system wants executed on behalf of it. I gave you the example of the packet filter earlier. So that's an example of downloading code into the kernel that needs to be executed on behalf of a particular guest operating system. And if you think about it, this idea of downloading code into the kernel is very similar to the spin idea of extending the kernel with logical protection domains that are created and dynamically linked in. Similarly, in the exokernel world, a library operating system can, if allowed by exokernel, securely download code into the kernel that will get executed under specific conditions that is laid down by the library operating system.